Hey everybody, Travis Watkins here. If you've been enjoying some of this content that we've been talking about with IRS relief, you're really going to want to jump on traviswatkinsbook.com and get yourself a free download of my book, The Ultimate Survival Guide for IRS Problems. We are going a little bit deeper into that book here, coming up with a whole new set of instructions and guidance on IRS problems, and so be expecting that here in the near future. Today we're talking about issues involving IRS problems that arise out of the filing of joint tax returns. In other words, if your IRS problem was caused by your spouse or your ex-spouse, as the case may be, then you're going to want to listen up. And let me just run right into this thing and show you kind of what we're talking about here. It's the IRS's Innocent Spouse Relief Program. And here it is, right here. Isn't that nice? Nice little slide there. The general rules for innocent spouse relief. Here they are. This one's called Classic Innocent Spouse Relief. It's the first one that we're going to be talking about here today. And this is the one that the great majority of the innocent spouse relief requests get made and accepted. For that matter, it's the broadest category that they have. Well, I guess, let me take that back. You'll see here in a minute, there's kind of a catch-all to all these things. So there's three types here. This is the first one, classic innocent spouse relief. It always starts with the innocent spouse filed a joint income tax return with someone else. And